If you have a low budget PC or laptop with 4GB RAM and 512MB graphics card and want to play some good games, then you have come to the right place. I have top 10 games with high graphics which you can run on a PC right now. Now for this list I have included different genres of games including open world, third person, first person, shooter and also point and click games so that you can have a wide variety of games to choose from. Before we begin with the list, make sure to subscribe and hit the post notification button so that you can get updates of my channel. Starting with number 10, Sniper Ghost Warrior. As a Ghost Warrior, it's an elite sniper in a highly trained special ops unit. Your unique skills in the art of stalking, target detection, surveillance and shooting accuracy will determine mission success. Now this game is perfect if you are into some first person shooter sniping. Number 9, Max Payne 3. No longer a New York City cop, Max Payne moves to Sao Paulo to protect a wealthy family in an effort to finally escape his troubled past. Combining cutting-edge shooting mechanics with dark and twisted story, Max Payne 3 is a seamless, highly detailed cinematic experience from Rockstar Games. If you are a fan of Rockstar Games and love third-person shooter, then you should definitely check this out.
It might have been stupidity, drunkenness, or maybe both.
On number 8, Outlast 2.
We're not alone.
A first-person survival psychological horror video game in which a journalist named Blake, along with his wife Lynn, roaming the Arizona desert to explore the murder of a pregnant woman only known as Jane. Blake and Lynn get separated in a helicopter crash and Blake has to find his wife while traveling through the village inhabited by a sect that believes the end of days are upon them. This game is going to give you nightmare for weeks. Trust me.
That's gotta be it. If I can find my way back to the elevator.
In this game, all you get is a camera and you have to fight a way through. And that's it. Good luck.
Oh, fuck me.
Number 7. Assassin's Creed series. In order to start playing Assassin's Creed, it's better to start from the first game itself and move to the corresponding games. And for that reason, I included Assassin's Creed 1, 2, Brotherhood, Revelations and 3. You can't really run games that were released after Assassin's Creed 3 really. So yeah, you can run up to Assassin's Creed 3. The story in this game is definitely worth your time. Trust me. Number 6, Sleeping Dogs. It's an action-adventure open-world game set in Hong Kong. The story follows that Wei Shen is an undercover Hong Kong American police officer on assignment to infiltrate the Sun Hung Yi Triad organization. The gameplay focuses on Shen's fighting, shootings and parkour abilities and on gadgets that can be used for combat and exploration.
Number 5, Life is Strange.
an episodic graphic adventure video game in which Meg Caulfield, an 18-year-old photography student, discovers that she has the ability to rewind her time at any moment, leading her every choice to enact the butterfly effect. After having foreseen an approaching storm, Meg must take on the responsibility to prevent it from destroying her town. This game will take you a different world as the story is great, trust me on that.
Where am I? What's happening? I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Number 4, Far Cry 3. An open-world action-adventure first-person shooter game set on a tropical island between the Indian and Pacific Oceans. Jason Brody, who is the main character of the game, is on vacation with a group of friends in the Rook Island celebrating his younger brother Riley getting a pilot license. However, on a skydiving trip, they land on a pirate-infested island and are kidnapped by Pirate Lord Vaas, who plans to sell them into slavery. Basically, the point of this game is to escape from the island. This game is literally the best game in Far Cry series and you must check it out.
Oh, holy fucking shit.
Number 3, Walking Dead series, a third-person graphic adventure video game series. It is a story-based game with point-and-click control. Basically, you have to make decision which will result in the cause and effect of the game. This game literally has the best story ever.
Oh shit! Oh, sell shit, the car wreck for the win! Oh shit! What the fuck? Q! Fucking Q! Fuck, my keyboard's about to get- Oh no! Oh god. Yeah, fuck off! Ooh, do you hear it crunch? Come on, come on, come on! Give me the hammer! Yeah, take that, bitch! Ooh. more time now for good luck. Oh my god.
Number 2, Mafia 2, an open world action adventure video game. This game is set in the 1940s, early 40s era of Empire Bay, which is a fictional city based on New York City. It is the best Mafia game in the Mafia series and a must play. Now before we begin with the number 1, let's take a look at the honorable mentions, Prototype 1 and 2. Coming with the number 1 on this list, GTA 5. This game has stormed the game industry. Within 24 hours of its release, Grand Theft Auto 5 generated more than $800 million in worldwide revenue, equating to approximately 11.2 million copies sold for Take-Two Interactive. 3 days after release, the game had surpassed $1 billion in sales, making it the fastest selling entertainment product in history. Now, a lot of people say that you can't really play GTA 5 on 4GB RAM. But you can if you have 512MB graphics. If you look up on the internet for the specification of GTA 5, then you will probably get that you can't run it unless you have 8GB of RAM with GTX 662GB or AMD 8078 72GB. Now I have tested and played GTA 5 on AMD A6 7310 APU with AMD R4 512MB graphics, 4GB DDR3 RAM, and it works fine at lowest setting possible at around 25 to 30 FPS, which is pretty much playable, I guess, for a cheap gamer at least. Now let me know in the comments section if you want me to do this test and actually show that it works. But before that, let me inform you that some of this game might not run at high settings and you might want to lower down the graphics as well as the resolution according to your PC specification in order to run these games. Alright, that's it for the video.